tone color palette is going to be just a little bit different than what I would normally do for a portrait, because he's got kind of this, like, sickly, mystical, like, pale look going on. We're going to mix in some of the blues in the background as well. These areas here where it's really shaded. Dark colors. It won't look like that when it's done. It's just the first layer. Bring in another light coat. Shadows here. Mm-hmm. don't want to forget. Got a little wrinkles on the forehead. Scrubbing on the first layer here, he's a little bit more flesh toned, and he's gonna appear in the end. He's gonna look a little more sickly when we're done. Blending in with these dark tones we applied a minute ago. Thank you. And just working in like really thin coats of scrub in the first layer of paint, kind of mixing the flesh tones with this bluish umber combo we got going on here. Coat's thin enough and it's just transparent enough that the lines that we initially drew here for the we're gonna place the pins. We still very clearly see these marks. I'm gonna repaint them so they'll look more with a little more depth. Once we get into the later coats. Down here and do parts of his chest that are showing through. Be a little darker, there's less of a glow down here. perfect, but I'm gonna clean up those areas. And I, a little more coverage down here, so you can still kind of see the underpainting through this. A little bit too much brown coming through, so we're gonna put another coat on that. And then when I do that, I'll fix these places because I know they're not perfect. And welcome to the stream. This is gonna be Pinhead from Hellraiser. He's looking a little crazy. This is the first coat of paint on his face. And there's no pins yet, so yeah, he kind of looks crazy right now. Pins will be the absolute last thing that I paint before I really go in and start adding some details and highlights. Just because it's so easy to accidentally paint over one. Oh, hi. I'm doing wonderful, Punk Saw. How are you today? Mm-hmm. trying to get all of this underpainting off the canvas. What you saw before, in certain places you still see the brown and stuff. That was all the underpainting. I did the entire thing in a burnt sienna wash. Now I'm laying the color on top of that. So I'm just trying to get rid of all of that now. Ugh, I didn't need that much paint. Mixing up what's going to be used as these strips here. It looks like from his costume that he's just got a strip of bloody flesh hanging down in front of the openings in the chest. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to paint some bloody flesh strips. Sounds like something that would be set in Borderlands. Bloody. A little warm down here, so we're gonna cool it. Miss Borderlands. I know, you like that even though you didn't like the robot. It's okay though. The punk ball. I'll give the little robot enough love for both of us. Just wants to be friends. Okay. It's probably going to be too dark, guys, but it's cool because it's the first coat and go from dark to light, so we'll put something lighter over top of this, but for now, I'm going to lay out some bloody flesh strips. Thank you. blazer with boobs. it's his outfit from... I want to say the third, but don't hold me to that. It won't look like that, hopefully. It's not totally like boobs. It's going to be like kind of bloody looking around here. But he basically has these long rectangular pieces cut out of his costume here. So he's got this big cloak and the front's cut out. Yeah, it's looking a little weird right now. Okay, again, this is the first coat, guys. So I usually go back with a lot of thin layers, do a lot of refining and little highlights and details that'll be added later on. Since we worked a little bit everywhere here, I'm letting it dry for just a second. The nipples. I just saw that bunks off. They are hidden behind the bloody